Hey guys, it's been a couple of months since my last upload, and I do apologize for the inactiveness of the channel. I was pretty busy with my college term for the past 3 months. I had a lot of reading and studying throughout this term, and I just felt tired after all that. But my term has finally finished, and I have about 2 weeks and a half to make 3D stuff again. I might just do some commissions and record those, so if some of you are interested, you can message me in Twitter. So, in this video, as you guys can see, I was just trying things out again and trying to remember my workflow. I wanted to make something cool for this video, but I opted for a much simpler low-poly portrait, just to get my groove back. I started with Blender since I have noticed that I make complex low-poly models much faster there. For this model, I did use the mirror modifier for the entirety of it since I didn't want to spend too much time detailing it. Plus, it meant that I only have to focus in detailing on one half. Honestly, I really like to use this modifier since after applying it, I could just manually move parts of the mesh to make it more asymmetrical. I was a bit nervous since it felt like I've forgotten a lot of the stuff I learned, but it was a relief that my muscle memory was able to kick in and just intuitively tell me where the usual keys were. Also, as you see here, I was able to remember how I usually do my ears. I mean, it was simple, but at least I know that my brain still functions and thinks the same way I used to 3 months ago. Now for the hair. I started with making a rough outline of the hair and keeping it all low poly since I didn't want to spend too many hours unwrapping and mapping all of those UVs. Also, unlike how I usually do it, I've separated the hair mesh for this one since connecting the two is what added too much time figuring out how I would connect it. Honestly, can you tell me guys if you prefer separate meshes for hair or for everything to be just in one mesh? After the outlines, it was pretty simple. I just connected all of it while making sure that most of the faces are squares. Then I just made some quick colors from the reference. Honestly, my belief when it comes to low poly models is to always make sure that the mesh is simple and just let the texturing do most of the heavy lifting. It's the same reason as to why I am debating whether or not I add mesh rigged eyes and mouth. It's cool, but I've been leaning more on the PS1 aesthetics, so I may change up my style a bit. So after making the model in Blender, I imported it into Blockbench for texturing. It was just a simple OBJ file, so nothing fancy. Since I used the mirror modifier in Blender, I made sure to delete one half of the mesh in Blockbench, since I could just duplicate and mirror it later in the process. I did this so that I wouldn't take too long organizing the UVs. Also, I've always preferred doing all my UVs in Blockbench, since I like to use the 256x256 for all my textures. As you can see here, I've done techniques to have more detail in lesser space. Plus, by doing this, I get to spend more time detailing the skin and transitioning the colors better. When I pick my colors, I always keep in mind to limit the gradients per color to 4 to 5 different tones. I do want to do textures from grabbing texture assets online and lining it up with the UVs, but Blockbench don't let me export the texture file with the UV line overlays. I know I could just do that in Blender, but I haven't figured that one out. I did do the same with the hair. This time, since I made my meshes have more squares than triangles, I was able to map it much easier. I didn't do too much fancy stuff for the hair, and just did a simple hair gradient. I'll let it play out a bit. For the clothes, it was more or less the same. Then, after all that, I connected all the meshes together and it's basically done. I also want to thank you guys for continuing to watch my videos. Honestly, after I decided to stop a bit, I thought the channel would die, but after checking it recently, you guys are still here, and I really appreciate that. Also, if any of you are interested from commissioning me, just hit me up in my Twitter. So here's how my UVs ended up looking. I know I could have resized some of the UVs, but it's not bad for a practice model. And here's the final model.